Yeah, I want to know everything. I want to know. Well, start from the first memory you have when you were in a boy.
It's the start of Detroit, yeah.
No, I want to know before Detroit. Well,
then I tell you, when my mother gave birth to me.
Yeah.
Oh, you got said it already.
It's done. It's working.
Okay. When my mother gave birth to me,
yeah,
she passed away the second day, the third day. You know, the whole country, you know, something to go wrong, they can do nothing, they can save nothing. And she passed away, and I'm named after her. Her name was Leigh, like Lisa Leigh.
Mm-hmm.
And they named me Ellie, named after my mother.
Mm-hmm. I didn't know that.
I know you don't know, because I don't think your father there even know this. But if you want to know, I tell you everything. Then I was maybe about 3-4 months, and my Zaide got a woman for me to take care of, feeding me with her breasts. And is it too low? This catches up. Is it too low? I'm talking too low.
I don't think so. Hold on. We'll stop it and then we'll check.
Okay. Nobody.
I'll check.
Would you mind to open it? It's gotten very warm.
It's a little warm.
Well, I kept it closed because you still got that.
I took a bath first thing in the morning.
Okay, so you're talking about when your mother died, and then you had a surrogate mother that was taking care of you and feeding you?
Yes.
Yeah.
And then my father was in the service. Then he went from the service, he came to see me when my mother passed away.
Mm-hmm.
He came to see
me. You know, I sent you a body card.
Yeah?
Same
back.
What was wrong there?
Oh, I haven't lived here in 2 years. I have a different address. I'll give it to you before I go. I will.
Okay, that's okay. Where did they put your birthday card somewhere?
Let me finish with Zaide. I want to hear the story, and then I'll get the card.
I'm
listening.
I'm not stopping you.
Well, sure you're stopping when you talk.
Okay, go ahead.
Then?
Your father came to see you.
I love my mom to see me. And then I kept them going. I become a year older. And they have the same woman taking care of me.
And this is where?
This. And on the whole country.
What do you say, the same woman? It must have been your grandma.
No, grandma. When my mother died, I had a woman feeding my breast.
That was, I know better than you. That was your aunt. She gave birth to a daughter. And she nursed you and her daughter at the same time. It must have been Ida's older sister,
yeah,
or younger sister, whatever.
Older.
Yeah.
I hear the story 50 times.
But I'm sorry, you're
I never heard the story. Would you scoot over a little bit? Because you're going to tell it together.
Over
I want to hear.
Okay,
yeah, you have to move over a minute.
Take this away,
no,
sir.
No. You're going to sit here in this chair so I can get you both. Here. I'm just gonna scooch over. You love him. You can sit next to him. Okay.
How can you get what to get him?
Oh, I have it. It's doing it now. It's doing it now.
What do you mean? You're like this. You sit near each other.
Yeah. I think that works out best.
You want the light or you don't?
No, the light's just fine. The light's just fine.
You see? Yeah, I look at my old guy. I almost lost him. You know, you said he was very sick this winter.
I know.
You
unfortunately. But look at him, he looks so good now.
Yeah, he looks good. Takes care of me. Mm-hmm. So I want to do something for him. He says, no, go, sit down. I said, I'm going to say, who's older, you or I?
So I want to finish. So your father came to see you. He was in what army?
The Russian army.
The Russian army? What was he? What was his position?
Mr. Soldier.
Plain soldier.
What's the matter with you?
Plain soldier. Anyway, And then when I was already a year or 2 years old, my Zaide took me, and my grandma used to take care of me, just like the one child. And I was...
I bet you she was a young woman, but in Europe, when a woman is 40, she's an old lady.
Oh, 40. Maybe not even 40, she was maybe 30 even, and she was already an old lady. You know, they live a different life. Anyway, when...
Don't you have something which registered when he talks?
It's working now. It's working now.
Good. Come on, talk. I'm going to tell him a story. My children always say, talk, mother, and register, but they never do it, so they haven't got it.
Well, now you have it.
And then I'll go, and they will not have it.
You're not going anywhere. This is so we can enjoy it all together.
Okay, good enough.
You're talking about to go goodbye.
Where are you going? I think you're moving to Washington, D.C.
Oh, do I love Washington.
Okay. Call up president and see, maybe he'll give you a job there.
No, I was visiting my cousin Larry. Yeah. They live in Washington, D.C. Not in Washington, D.C. But...
What was it? The little city.
I know, right outside of Washington. I was outside of Philadelphia and
you know, like that.
What's the next state?
It's the same state.
Maryland, Virginia.
Maryland. They live in Maryland. When they first got married, you know, they didn't have, did they have any children? No. They never had children.
I didn't know that.
No, they didn't have any children for 10 years. Then he's a doctor, you know, Leonard. Mm-hmm. Larry. Do you mind if I
don't want their story. I wanted to talk, but I want to finish.
I'll tell them that story.
No, okay. that's 100 years later than this. So we can't jump 100 years.
Okay, go ahead. Finish it, Albert.
It's a long story.
Anyway.
So you went, now you're with your grandmother.
I was with my grandmother and grandfather. And we lived in a village.
Yeah.
And when I got growing up, I had to go to school. We had to go to a little town across the river. I had to go with a boat. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I was going there in the little town.
He probably never wanted to go.
You never wanted to go to school?
Not that I'm saying.
I wanted to go. I was staying there in the little town.
In the little town?
By an uncle of mine.
Yeah.
My daddy's supporter. And that time there was all young people. He was not old. Anyway, when I grew up, when I was already about mitzvah, see, when you don't have no mother, you bar mitzvah, not no more than 13, 12.
When you don't have a mother, it's 12?
12.
I didn't know that.
My brothers got bar mitzvah to 12. Okay. When you haven't got one parent, you have bar mitzvah at 12. My father died when he was only 42 years old. What did I always tell you, 42 or 44?
42 or 43 or 44. Not much difference.
Not much difference.
Anyway, I was going to a little town, and I had to go back to the village with a boat, with a canoe. And I used to be a devil. Take the canoe middle of the river and rock the boat. And some people was with me, they started screaming, "What are you doing?" And I was very bad.
That's where my dad got it. From him. Hmm? That's why my dad was so bad.
Your father was such a good child, like a little angel, telling me.
Yeah,
your father.
By the way, see, last week when his birthday, we announced on the shul.
You know, when it was your father's birthday, I went to shul, as sick as I am. I went to shul, and in our shul everybody announces Simchas. So I get up, and the rabbi calls me by my first name, says, "Ida, you." So I said, today is our younger son's birthday, 25th of May, mm-hmm. 56 years old, and all the angels were singing. And the rabbi said, really, all the angels were singing when Fred came? Yes. And you know, other people asked me, what happened when your other son was born? I said, well, the angels were dancing.
See, we belong right as a little shul, mm-hmm. Shalom.
Mm-hmm. It's not a little shul, it's a nice synagogue.
A neighborhood shul.
Okay.
Anyway.
So you were a devil, always rocking the canoe.
Rocking the canoe. And anyway, when I come back home, people was always talking about me, I'm doing this wrong and doing this wrong. But I let go of everything. And then...
People were talking about what?
Saying that he was a bad guy.
Bad guy.
A bad boy.
I took him out middle of the river and rocked the boat. Well, anyway...
It probably was a small lake.
A small what?
A small lake. Lake.
Sure,
lake. So you say river. From a lake, from a small lake till a river is a big thing. Because I know we live near a lake.
Anyway, when I become older and I had a bar mitzvah, I had to go to the little town that a rabbi used to, you know, teach you the bar mitzvah.
Did you know what? Did you know how to dance?
Sure.
Yeah.
Thank you.
If you would know it then you would know it.
Really. Yeah, I don't know now.
Well, you know it, but you're not a very...
not well. I'm picking up the swallow.
Don't you dare. My son's...
So when you went to learn the bar mitzvah, it was in the other village?
Yeah, then we have to go over the canoe. And really was a rough time, see. You had to go there and spend
And when your father wanted to take you to England, when your father remarried, how old were you then?
That time I was maybe 11, 10 or 11 years old.
Your father remarried?
Yeah, he remarried. In fact, he has. I had two sisters. Hitler killed them, both of them. I saw him only once. In Rotterdam, in 1914, 1916.
Did you see him? Good-looking girls?
Beautiful.
Is that right?
Yeah. Ah. I saw him, I think, only one time, twice.
This was from your mother or your father's second wife?
Second wife. My mother was only 19 years old.
His mother only had one child, him, and she died by giving birth. That's why he's named after his mother. His name is Leah. But in a man is Eli.
Mm-hmm. Then when I grown up and I was by my Zaide, and my Zaide, they treat me like just like their own child. You see.
Of course.
And really,
a grandson is a grandson.
No.
It's a son.
No.
Grandson.
Europe is not. Europe is more closer. You have been also close. Grandchildren with grandparents. Maybe at that time. Mm-hmm. Well, anyway, when I was 11 years old, and my father had already two little girls.
I know, my grandparents were very close with us. My grandfather used to call me, Oide. You know, my name is Ada in Yiddish. Ada. But my grandfather comes from Odessa, you know, they talk with the O. You know
Odessa?
Odessa, yeah. So you used to call me Hoidia. Hoidia. My grandfather loved me very much.
Anyway.
A red-headed gentleman.
He was red-headed?
I told you my grandfather was red-headed. My aunt, my father, had only one sister. How many brothers? My father.
Five brothers.
And do you call Moshe too?
Yeah.
Avraham and Moshe, you figure them too?
Avraham, Moshe, and David. And.
David, Louis, Charlie, Sam, How many you have? I think it's more than five.
Maybe seven.
That's I think they are.
Seven.
Seven brothers but and anyway, sisters. My aunt is still alive, you know, my father's sister.
The stones, you know, the
Stone. You remember
right,
Uncle Stone?
Right.
That's
right.
My his wife is my father's sister.
A stepsister, isn't it? A stepsister.
Ah, that we never called step or anything.
I know.
I never did that. Never. None of us. Till we came here. So my cousin Bob, you know, said a picture from my Zaide and my Baba. I never knew she was a step Baba. She was my Baba. You know. He tore the picture in half. It's not my Baba. You know,
the dummy.
It's a terrible thing to
do. But anyway.
And she raised his father. He was only 9 months.
Up by that. Let's leave alone. This.
Go ahead. Then but talk with the little guy. Come alive.
Then when my father got married.
Right, so you had the two little girls and you.
And me, I was never by him. Then he wanted to take me to him.
After you'd been with your grandfather for so long. Who is your family now?
Yeah. And anyway, he come to want to take me. I say, I'm not going. When my Zaide don't go with me, I'm going. The Zaide say, yeah, I'm going. And we went in an awesome buggy, you know, with not a car, just...
Where did you go to?
He lived in a different village.
What village? Do you remember the name?
Yeah, but it's so hard to say it.
Sikile!
Little...
Sikile!
Sikilia?
Yes, Sikilia.
But anyway, when we come in before the little town, before you got to go to his house, my Zaide went down from the horse and buggy, and he hid himself in the woods. And my Zaide's not there. I say, I'm not going. Zaide don't go with me, I'm not going. Because I don't know nobody. I know it's just Zaide. I didn't know no mother, no father. And this was the closest one.
He never went to live with his father.
You then, never went to live with your father?
No, he
did
never...
Did you find your Zaide?
Zaide was right with
I thought he hid in the woods.
Well,
yeah,
the wagon was there too.
He just wanted to see what I'm going to do.
What's going
to
happen?
And I started screaming, crying. I don't want to go. I want to go back to my Zaide.
So he went back to Zaide, and that's certainly lived with his Zaide. Maybe if he would have gone with his father, maybe he would have gone to school, maybe he would have gone to... Who knows what he would have been?
Maybe be a doctor, a lawyer.
Maybe you would have never met him.
So, but no big thing.
See how she is?
Then my Zaide, when I was already about 13 years old after my bar mitzvah, in 12 years old, that's right. And that time started the war in 1914, you know, Russian and Japanese war. I think it was German, I think Russian.
1914, yeah.
Russian, German.
No, but Japan. Germany was
1914.
Later. 1914. 1914, Russia and Japan went to war.
5 years old.
Then, let's see. Yeah.
You were 12 then.
12 or 13 is not different.
Yeah, okay.
Then,
Come on.
Yeah, I don't want to tell no stories. I won't tell.
I don't want to miss anything.
Yeah, that's right. Now,
so the war started.
The war started, and my Zaide passed away. My Zaide and my Baba. The war started. We didn't have no shul in our village. We had to go to the little town.
Right.
We was there, and while we was there, the soldiers burned up our house. Everything, just like we had the clothes to go to shul, that's all we got left. And my Zaide...
And your Bubby and Zaide came with you?
Sure. This was after already, we wanted to go to my father. My talk was already back.
Right.
back over there in the old, little village. Smelled him, I don't know what to call it.
I know, a lot of people came to our city, we called them businesses.
Refugees.
Refugees, yeah. They came from other cities, took them into our house, mm-hmm. gave them food. Gave
during
them
the war.
Yeah, during the war.
And where were you? Where were you at this time?
We didn't come from the same places.
Where were you from at this point?
I come from Russia.
Mm-hmm. Mine was Ukraine, Poland. Mm-hmm. Well, anyway, we...
So you came in that city with your Bubby and Zaide. Come on, alive!
And the village was burnt down.
The village went burnt down, and we didn't have nothing.
So where did you go?
Nothing, we were there. We were there in the, little town.
No, I thought maybe you went to the big city.
No,
because
no,
that's
no,
where the Jewish people went.
Later we went to the big city.
So when you came back, you found the house was burnt down. Is that when your Zaide died?
Later, he got sick. Mm-hmm. No, we was over there in the little town yet, not before we went to the village.
I thought you said that died from typhus.
Not from typhus, not from worry, even. I don't know, typhus, I don't know. What
typhus
was.
Happened.
Well, anyway.
What typhus. Was his name? What was your Zaide's name?
Bill.
What was his last name?
Your father.
Oh, his last name
Bill,
is...
Bill, no, Uncle David.
David is David Bernard, Bell.
Bill.
And Fred is Froyen Yankel.
Yankel is
Fred J. Your father's name is Fred J.
Then this was my Zaide's son, my mother's brother.
Your father's named after him.
My mother's brother.
A real...
my mother's brother. And your uncle.
He wasn't a rabbi. He was a teacher. Very learned person. Oh, my Zaide Foy, my Uncle Foyer, that's your father named after that man. Mm-hmm. What a man. That's for your father. Your father is a wonderful man. And a million.
Well, anyway, it was that time. My Zaide got sick and my Baba got sick. Yeah. Just not sick enough for typhus, when it is no pneumonia or no, just from Voiv, and we lived in a little one room, just like this room, or my room was smaller yet. And my Zaide was laying in one bed, and my Baba was. My Zaide died right over there in the room.
That's what in Europe was.
And my Baba, said to me, while you die there, they fix you right up, they wash your hand, and they put you on the shred.
Trachricha. Mm-hmm. Well, in Jewish, it's Trachrichem. Does it have an English name?
But it's shred, isn't it?
To what?
Shred. Would you dress about
in English.
Oh, shroud. Shroud.
Shroud. Yeah. Shroud. But shroud. In Jewish, they call it Trachrichem.
The white shroud.
Yeah. That's it, right. Mm-hmm. But anyway,
and then a talus. Mm-hmm. A man always goes with his talus.
Well, when you're sure, then... Then my Baba said to me, she was laying in one bed and he's already dead. They fixed him up right in the bed. They fixed him up, they put on the shroud and everything. And my Baba said to me, Zaide, why don't you give him Zaide number some milk? In Yiddish. Why don't you give him Zaide number some milk? I said, I couldn't say nothing to her because he was dead already. Mm-hmm. And she had a lot of fever. And they fix them up and they take you right out and take you to the cemetery. They don't put you in a box, just...
Right, right.
And they carry you.
And here it's a big honor if they carry you out.
I know. But here you don't care, just a rabbi, big people. And they took him out. And then 3 days later, he died, let's see, like a Tuesday, she died Friday. 3 days later, 4 days later, she died. Then when they both died, I got left for myself. Mm-hmm. Then I had my uncle, my mother's brother,
mm-hmm.
working.
Mm-hmm.
Also, right?
Yes, no problem.
My mother's brother lived in a bigger town, Lutsk. And the
Is this the uncle that you were? Which I have a picture from your uncle in
hand? Yeah, sure.
Oh. Is the uncle that you went to go live with next?
Yeah.
So his name is what?
Salman.
His name?
Salman.
What's his last name?
Salman is his name.
The last name?
Rubinstein.
Oh, I see.
And my mother's daughter.
Mm-hmm. What was your father's last name?
My father was last name Appleman.
I never know if it's Appleman or Applebaum. Is it Appleman or Applebaum?
Appleman. But I never been in that name.
Mm-hmm.
I was with my mother's family. I never was seen there, the other family. I never knew him.
Sure, he was with his mother's. So he went, goes on his mother's name, Rubinstein.
Mm-hmm.
When we got married, he asked me, what do you think you should have, Rubinstein or Appleman? So why should you have Appleman when you never went with Appleman?
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Anyway.
So you went to go live with your mother's brother?
Yeah. And they had one boy, same age as me, and a little girl older and a little girl younger.
Where are they?
Where's my other people?
Oh,
where's
all the Hitler killed them.
Hitler killed them.
I'm also Hitler's dead. He poisoned himself.
Yeah, good. He should have poisoned himself way before. Anyway. And,
come up till you went to Cuba.
No, I want to hear.
Oh, come on,
I got to
hear plenty yet.
Okay, but come on.
Yeah, I got time.
I've got time, and I come back tomorrow. Yeah, it'll take as many days. I'm here to be with you. I don't care about anything.
Okay, come on.
Then, I want to got to remember, see, that these things. See,
right. Then you went to go live with your mother's brother.
That's it.
And he had a brother, a son the same age as you.
Maybe.
Were they good with you, the children?
Oh, yeah. Anyway, then there are like a little grocery. They sell like flour and, you know, not like here, a big supermarket. It's a small neighborhood little grocery. And I used to work in there on the grocery.
How old are you at this time?
Oh, maybe about 14 years old. And one lady come in the store, and she asked me, where's your mother? And I say, my mother's in Dredd. And Dredd in Yiddish, you know. Ooh! They thought I'm one of the children, see? Because they treat me the same like the children. Oh, this bad boy, I'm going to tell your mother when she comes in. Aunt come in and he tell her the stories. But I asked for you and he told me, you're dead. I said, yeah, his mother is really bad. I'm not his mother. It's just my nephew. and most of the people, small little town, and still people don't know that I'm a stranger or I'm from the family.
Well, you are from the family and they love you.
I mean, like their own child. This one. I was there for all till I was becoming 19, 20 years. Then I decided I want to go to America.
When was the first time you heard of, were a lot of people going to America then?
Oh, sure.
1919, was it 1918?
No, 1924.
That's when everyone started to go to America?
Yeah,
that's what you went, 1924?
24 to Cuba.
Because we went to Cuba in 1925.
You went a year before.
No, you went a year before. You went 1924.
Yeah.
And you went 1925.
Why did you go to Cuba?
I couldn't come to America.
Mm-hmm. And you were by yourself?
By myself.
Mm-hmm.
And then my uncle sent me some money to go to America. And that time, America was closed. The border was closed.
They didn't let him.
They didn't let him. It's a lot of agencies that give idea of Cuba, Mexico, of any of these countries. And then from there, you'd be able to come into America.
Did you have a lot of relatives who moved into America before you moved?
My mother's brother.
Why didn't she go there?
The went later, the Uncle Lazo. Uncle Lazo, I went to
America. Uncle Lazo's in America.
Later, I went.
Had he gone, he went before you.
Oh, Uncle Lazo is here.
Okay. Yeah, but they didn't let him into America.
When did Uncle Lazo came to America?
In 19...
Before the Mahoma.
Oh, yeah, before.
Okay.
1914.
Before 1914.
So you went into Cuba?
Then I couldn't come to America, I went to Cuba.
And you were how old?
When I was to Cuba, I was 20 years old. By myself. And I don't check how much money I had. Nothing. I mean nothing. Mm-hmm. $1.
But didn't your uncle give you a couple of dollars?
They don't have it themselves that time.
Okay.
It was a very bad time. But when you come to America, before you go down from the boat, you have to show that you will not go on a charity case, that you got some money to live for a month. Then my girlfriend was gone with me. He had money. He gave me the $30. Just $30.
Who was that?
Yoshka.
Oh, Yoshka had money.
See, this was our boyfriend. It was already signing each name and marriage people.
He called me Ida Singer. Sent me a picture. Joseph Singer, Ida Singer.
It was a very, very funny life, very funny. Very
you met him in Cuba?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you went to America and you had the $30, but they didn't let you in?
First I went to Cuba. Mm-hmm. But from Cuba to come to America, you have to...
How long were you in Cuba?
1924 to 1932. 8 years.
So you got to Cuba and you had no money. What did you do?
Paddle.
The next day, my boyfriend, as I tell you, give me the $30. We become partner. We bought a little. Yeah, this is a good story. Then we go out and buy socks, handkerchiefs, shoelaces, razor blades, you know.
And ties.
In Cuba.
In Cuba.
Yeah, I know. My brother had it also.
And we had a little box and put all this in a little box and put it.
And you hold it up here.
The box with the leather belt and carried right in the.
Cravata.
Right like this.
Yeah.
And people walk up and they see shoelaces, they need shoelaces, or they need the handkerchiefs. And pennies, not dollars, not. Anyway, he was there. And
he gave you $30 and you came here.
You keep wanting to go too fast.
And we were partners. Yeah. I had to
as soon
go
as you come down, he gave him the $30 back.
Uh-huh. But later we opened in partnership. He put his money, I didn't have a penny.
So you were selling the ties.
But a fine gentleman. Huh? Yoshka is.
Yeah,
Yoshka.
He was very good. It was all very fun. Poor girl, I took her away from him. But a rich man.
No, he wasn't a rich man. But he always used to say, Ida, and he used to take me out. So we went to the streetcar. That time was a streetcar. But a couple of blocks before my home, he wanted to show my mother that he's a rich fella. He took a cab just for a couple of blocks.
But anyway, then we become partners. He used to go in the morning and walk maybe 2-3 hours and don't sell for one penny. And he come home. I used to take an afternoon and walk out the right away and to the restaurant with people.
You see, the same sitting. They couldn't afford two stores, that one store. One was working in the daytime, one was working in the afternoon.
This was going on for a couple of months. Yeah. Anyway. I went like this with the little box. In the afternoon, I made it maybe $2. $2 was big money, just like now, $200.
Sure.
And
we had to stand in Philadelphia. We used to take in $50 a week. take in. But we
no,
didn't.
No, much more. We used to take a sale of $50. For the big, maybe another $20.
Okay, so we never said we took in $50. We said we made $50. We didn't make it. It wasn't ours. It was, you know, yes. The profit was ours.
Well,
how much profit do we have from $50?
Half and half.
Boy, well, come on, finish the story, Albert.
Well, where am I?
We were talking that you were in the. He would sell nothing in the morning. He would go in the afternoon and sell everything.
The only thing I cannot believe it is that Harmon was a more aggressive, a better businessman. So I cannot believe it that he didn't make nothing and he made. You're not going to tell me that. Not Yoske, because Yoske can sell you and buy you and sell you.
See what kind of trouble I got?
Yeah. But that's true. He's an aggressive fella, a more educated fella. You know, a different boy. Mm-hmm. So, you're going to tell me to Yoske?
Well, I was the other one, okay?
Okay.
But it doesn't matter. So if you sell, it's not because you're better. But the American people didn't get up first thing in the morning.
And this I tried to tell you.
They get up later. That's why.
Do we sell the stuff to tourist people?
To tourists from America.
America. They used to.
Beets. Oh, that's what they did. They used to sell beets.
Oh, boy. We used to have beets. They made right there in Orchard Lake, in New York, how you call it? Orchard Street,
mm-hmm.
You know, we buy all the barns. And we used to tell them
to take him to Cuba to sell it to the American people.
And we used to tell them this made in Cuba. And
what was it?
Beads.
Beads?
Beads. Beads.
Oh, beads.
They made them in America. They sent them to Cuba to sell to American people.
And we used to tell them it's made over there in jail. But how do we used to sell them? Sometimes we used to go to the restaurants, to the beer gardens. But later we get back, come a little bit, work ourselves up. Then I got a little box, and he got a little box. I made enough money.
Separate business.
I made already enough money, made it was for myself.
To buy a box.
But still, we were still partners. When the tourists used to come in, they take him like to show the cathedrals, show the synagogue, show them different places, you know.
And they gave the American boy chick, a dollar, you know.
Mm-hmm. What were they talking?
I say when you show the American people where the Jewish synagogue is or where the Jewish cemetery is.
I didn't used to show them. They was going with cars.
A tour.
A guide.
Oh, I thought maybe you showed it.
No, we used to run up.
Oh, they have a guide. Cuba's a beautiful place.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we were in Cuba. We were in Cuba, and there are beautiful people go there for vacation. We live there every day.
Just like Florida.
So you would go onto the running board and sell to the tourists?
The beats right in my hand, and a little box with pocket knives.
But tell him how when you became rich, what happened?
Oh, well, come on.
When you had to stand there.
I want to hear you selling beads to the tourists by hanging on the cars when they pull up to the site.
There you go. And sometimes you have to run while the car goes.
Are you sleeping? Looks like your eyes are closed.
Do me a favor. Sometimes the car goes. And you stay right in the running board.
Until they buy something.
You don't let them go, sure. In Philadelphia, you didn't need no Cuba. In Philadelphia, when we had a stand, yeah? And the people used to go out and drag the customers to their store. There was a clothing store by the corner, I remember. So the salesman used to come, and we were by the front, you know, with the pushcarts out. And say, we have suits today, half price, a bargain, this and that, and actually
that. Push you right in the store.
You know. And by the stand, you used to stay by the stand, you know. And I used to call for the shoes. What do you do? Shoelaces.
Shoelaces.
3 shoelaces for a nickel.
You're going too fast though, because I know that you're in Cuba
okay,
now.
Come on.
No, before you got to Cuba, when you were in Russia.
Let him finish. I'll tell you.
Okay.
Then when I was over there, sold him something. Then we had a partner, but he had his own business, and I had my own business. I used to come at night time, used to make, we had already made $5 a day or $10 a day.
They took in $5, so they said they made $5.
This was already big money, see? Then later on, I got in a hotel, a stand that sells cigars and cigarettes and souvenirs.
That's big business. I bet you some man who knew how to do it made good money.
Perfumes and all different things. And then after this finish...
Do you remember the name of the hotel?
Hotel Ritz.
You know the hotel.
Hotel Ritz.
Mm-hmm. But they were, soon as they took in a couple of dollars, and after supper, and after a show, they went out. They didn't stay no longer.
It's really, we didn't have nothing, we didn't need no nothing.
No, youngsters.
We made enough to do it for today, it was enough, we didn't have to worry about tomorrow.
One fella in Cuba, he went after my sister Molly. He was older, he was my brother, the action sage. So, how old was he? He 2 years older than you, yeah?
He was
20, the other guy was 22. So he went after my sister Molly. He liked her. He had parents in America. He didn't do nothing. His parents are rich people. His father worked in a shoe factory.
They make the letters.
Poor thing. Made the letter and got pneumonia. And that guy, what a lousy thing. Didn't go to work. His parents are in America. He doesn't have to work. And he went after my sister Molly.
He was staying every day waiting for the mailman.
Waiting for money to come from America.
Yeah. Can you imagine that?
No, I soon I got in my own.
I lost my respect. I was a different type of kid. As young as I was, you know, I had big cell, grown-up cell, you know. I lost my respect for that fella. 22-year-old boy, he waited for his poor father to send him that bloody dollars.
Yeah, he was working not only in a shoe factory much, but the prepare and making the leather.
You know, you get pneumonia from it.
It's very stinky, very, you know, the skin from a cow, from a...
You know.
What year did you have the place in the hotel? How long had you been in Cuba?
He was in Cuba till 1932.
No, but how long before, from when you first got to Cuba, till you had the place in the hotel?
Almost about 3 years, 2-3 years. Mm-hmm. And then...
How much was the rent? That big business is sent in a hotel.
Anyway,
I would make big business from it.
You because he was not there. When you would be there, you would make $1 million. Anyway, I was staying in a hotel, and when I got a stand in a hotel, I was staying there all day and night.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't know when the people coming in America, and they buy the gifts. I always was there. One day, I met a couple fellas that used to come from the country.
You say it was very good looking, you know, that at 20. He had hair. So thick, curly hair. You remember you say it with curly hair?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'll show you the picture. You see it.
Yeah. Oh, come on. Anyway, let's see. You know, it's very hard to adjust the talk. You gotta remember exactly.
So you're talking about you had to stay there all the time because you didn't know when the tourists were going to come, and you met some guys from America, you were saying. You said you met three guys came in one day from the old country, or?
No, from Cuba.
Yeah.
Three politicians that were staying in this hotel, like senator, congress people.
This picture we took, the first day we got married, the first Seder. Look at the hair. And see, this is the picture when we got married. See, my bridesmaids. See, that's me. Young little girl, you know. That's Zaide. That's my brother and his future wife. And that's my sister-in-law's brother, my girlfriend. She died 5 years ago or so. And that's my sister Annette, the fella. And that's my brother and his wife, Ray. You remember Auntie Ray?
Mm-hmm. That's Auntie Ray?
Auntie Ray, she has...
Oh, and that's Harry.
Yeah, she has all time.
They're both sick. They're both really sick. They both live in Florida now.
Mm-hmm.
They live in Florida in a senior citizen home.
Well, anyway...
Anyway, I'll look at this later.
Three people come in there
right.
from the country.
Anybody want Steve while we're sitting like this?
No, I'm fine.
Okay.
Then come in one of the senator, congressman, or another big, three people, and they start to talk that the new president, President Machado, when he be elected, they're going to make a lot of money. What? Because they're going to build a lot of things to make money. Then he walks over to me, says, Albert, in Spanish you call me Elias.
Albert, how did they used to call you?
Elias.
Elias?
Elias.
Oh, Elias.
And he say, we are looking for somebody. They're going to have a big casino they're building right over there in a certain park near the president.
Yeah.
It's still good?
Yeah, still good.
They're going to build a casino there. Casino is supposed to be Machado's, the president's, his business.
Mama, shall I give a call up to the jewelry store, see if my ring is ready?
No. Forget it, Ida.
Okay.
You don't need no jewelry store. Then he say they're going to build a casino in this place by the president, where the president's palace is. You know, the White
House. Right, the president's going to have the power, so it'll be a big casino.
Big casino. But could be nothing in his name.
I think I'm going to go down, take a look if I have somebody.
Go ahead. Congressmen or senators, it was in their name. Then he said to me, we're looking for somebody to build a souvenir stand to sell souvenirs. And he explained it to me how he won it and all this. And we were still partnering with the other fella.
Right.
And the stand was, he had one stand in a hotel and I had another one. It was not a partnership. I had one for him and one for me. Then he said to me, you're going to build a souvenir stand. And he asked me, would that be interesting? Sure. Then anyway, he gives a plan which one are you want him to build. And we called the man, he asked $300 for this stand to build. $300 for me, $300 for my partner.
Right, so it costs $1,200 to have a big new stand.
No, $600. And I opened up the first night. We took in, let's see, $50. we made $40 profit in the 50s. See, you know, we sold something for a dollar, it cost 20 cents. Or something for $5, it cost a dollar. And the girls was working there, the waitress, they used to get a commission. Anyway, we would be a millionaire girl when we'd let her stay. But 3 days later they start critiquing, you know, the president, he has a gamble place. And they closed it up. And I left, I lost everything I built up, cost me about $300.
How many days?
3 days.
3 days, and then they killed the president.
No, they didn't kill the president, they killed the concession.
The concession.
They closed up the concession. Because it was too big of gambling was going on there. And there was, you know, the papers started to kill me. The president, he has gambling business. And I lost everything I put it in. I think it was
Why 10. Did you lose it?
The money, but I built a stand.
Well, they robbed you, you mean?
Huh?
No, they closed it.
They what?
They closed the casino.
Uh-oh.
They closed the casino 3 days only. When we stayed there for 6 months, we make a fortune. 3 days, we made enough money to take out enough money for to take out what cost us. And,
that's what I say. A stand in a hotel is big business.
And you have to take out all the merchandise. The stand still stays there now. I talked to a fellow, but not now. I mean, talking 20 years later.
Yeah.
Or 30, people were coming just from Cuba. You know, they were.
Is that, which was the hotel? You told me once a story that you met Albert Einstein. Which hotel was that?
Oh, Pearl de Cuba. Pearl de Cuba. Albert Einstein.
That was after the casino?
Yeah. I couldn't figure out. This was after the casino.
Yeah.
And we were staying there for only a few days, that's all.
Right, you said.
Let's see. That's it then.
Okay.
Then I decided, I lost the money, everything, I decided to go to America.
Mm-hmm.
And I wrote to my uncle, to my cousins, they all sent me some money to come to America.
Had you had already known Bubby then?
Yeah, we just
knew each other. Since I was 15 years old.
We knew each other, but she had a boyfriend.
Who was your boyfriend?
My partner. Yoshi.
Yoshi Singer.
Yeah, she had a boyfriend. He had signed her name already, Mr. and Mrs. Singer.
He didn't say Mr. and Mrs. He said Yoshi Singer and Ida Singer.
Oh, yeah, Ida Singer.
So did he go to America with you, or?
Yeah, sure, we went to America, he went to...
What, really? You went to get to America?
He went to New York.
He married another girl.
He went to New York.
How could a fellow like Yossel marry a stick nothing like that woman he married?
No, he didn't come. Dutka come with me. No, he didn't come. He was there later, he moved to Florida, to Miami.
He has a big store in Miami.
Before you leave Cuba, though, I wanted to hear the story that you met Albert Einstein. You were going to tell me.
Oh, this was way before that. Albert Einstein come in with his daughter. They used to come every year to this hotel, Perla de Cuba. Perla de Cuba, the name of the hotel. And when any time American tourists come, and the Jewish, they always spoke over to me and they reduced themselves.
The restaurant.
and start to talk in Yiddish. His daughter was always with him just like a babysitter. Mm-hmm. He asked me to go to the Jewish restaurant. I called a taxi, we went to Houston. The taxi cost a quarter to go there, don't forget. A whole quarter.
Then
we went there, and he ordered some meat, I don't know, I think it was meat, yeah. And they give you a fork and spoon and a knife. And he was eating, the platter was staying just like this. And he took the fork to take the meat. He was pushing the fork all over, but not in the meat. He was always thinking. And we become very close. He never walked out, no place, till he see me. He was maybe about 8 or 10 days. In this hotel, but
did he talk a lot?
Very little. His daughter used to talk to him. Talk very little. But
his daughter used to talk for him. Better than Albert Einstein. His daughter used to talk. Albert Einstein. Huh?
Why, you think that story?
No, I know that. Very big people, they don't talk.
You have no time to talk. Just like Emily, the one talk. I talk, why I say the Mark, how come Emily don't talk? She didn't have to talk. She has a big sister. Talk to her. They say it was with him. It was too much time.
Were they up when you came to see him last night?
Then he was...
Who went for dinner?
Were you together when you were in Cuba? Just my dad and I. Just my dad.
When you Your mother didn't go?
No. When you were in Cuba is when... When did you decide to go with him to America?
I decided to go with him to America.
No.
Are you crazy or something?
You crazy or something?
I didn't go with him to America. Yeah. We lived in the same apartment.
Mm-hmm.
This apartment. It's a big apartment. But Cuba's big apartments too.
Mm-hmm.
We lived in the same apartment. He lived with how many boys? Three boys.
Four
boys in one bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
We lived in one bedroom. It was a big bedroom. It has a crystal chandelier. In one bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
This is the bedroom, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So up here stayed a double bed. And up here stays a double bed. And up here stays a day bed. And under the bed stays another. Day bed to open up. Okay. So one bed slept. Ida, Marley and Annette.
This is really something.
Yeah.
And this bed slept. She had four brothers. So one brother was in America, yeah? So in this bed was Gershon, Simon and Eric. This bed. Three people. Okay. My mother slept under the bed.
And after this, wait a minute, after this she still have a brother.
Wait, let me tell you. I said abuse is a day bed. And abuse is a day bed. So my mother slept in the day bed. And abuse was a day bed. Mm-hmm. So we had a roomer. Abuse. Then we had a little old. So we also had a bed there. So we had another roomer. So we had two roomers in one room. We were six children and my mother is seven. And two roomers is nine.
Mm-hmm. And how did you come to live in the same apartment?
Here is another room in apartment. It's 15 floors. Mm-hmm. What do you mean? He lived in another room.
Over there was only two floors, right up.
I know, but it's a lot of rooms. He lived in another room with four boys. It was a lot of rooms. A lot of people lived there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I never bothered with him. I was 15 years old, he was 20.
Too old.
You know.
Too old.
He was an old guy. The other fellow was an old guy too. He was a different boy. He was dancing, he was singing. I didn't go with him. I didn't bother with him. You know. but that is the truth. You know.
Then I was much better. Ian, thank you for coming.
Feel a little better?
Ian, thank you for coming.
Okay. No, move back over there. I want to hear more, though.
Oh, you want to hear the story when we came to Cuba?
When you
my
came?
My mother and the children?
Yeah.
Okay. Shall I tell you the story of the beginning? And my father died and everything?
That's what I'd like to hear.
Wait a minute. Where did we finish?
Let him finish.
Where did you finish? You finished that you decided you were going to go to America after the casino closed.
Just to tell you how that came, and that's it. Then after I decided, see, you couldn't come to America legitimately. I had to go to the agent, cost a lot of money.
Why?
Because they don't let us into America.
Oh. Where did you go?
The agent. Agent.
They paid the money and they made them false papers.
Oh, it went to an agent, yeah.
They make different papers, no bullshit.
Well, I'll start telling you from where I come from.
I want to finish. He's almost to America. I want to hear when he comes to America, then I want to hear from where you come from.
I come to America and I come to Florida. First, he comes to Florida, the Key West. And then I come to Miami. From Miami, I come with the bus to Philadelphia. And my uncle and my cousin.
You couldn't possibly come with the bus to Philadelphia.
Why?
Because, you know how long it took for the bus?
24 hours.
What year was that?
1932.
Wait a minute, 1932, we was married, right? Talk about
19. We got married in 1934.
Now I want to hear the story about you and...
Okay, I'm going to tell you from where I come from.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I come from my mother and father. My father was 25 years old. My mother was 18 when they got married. My mother didn't have no dad, just a mother.
Mm-hmm.
And they come from a small little town, and they had like, and here it would be a hotel, but there it's called Eiferos, people used to come there with wagons,
like a boarding house.
Yeah, and my grandma had a big place to keep the horses with the wagons there, and the people used to come into the house to eat supper and to sleep over. And then they took care of the horses. That was my mother's.
Like a motel.
Yeah.
Well, that was my mother's home. My mother came from. Okay. When my father came from service, he was 25 years old, and I suppose they introduced him or whatever. I don't know. And they got married. And years ago, when a fella got married, he had 3 years or how many years that the brides. Parents supported him with a home and with food and with everything. But my father was already a well, worldly man. He was in service for many years, so he didn't want to. So he took my mother and went to city, the big city.
What city?
Novograd-Volinsk, it's Russian.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he came there.
What's it called?
Novograd-Volinsk.
Mm-hmm.
And he came there, and I don't know what they rented, a house or whatever. And my mother had two miscarriages before she had my brother Gershon, you know. Mm-hmm. And she had my brother Gershon, and she had my brother Leo, and she had my brother Sam. And when my mother had my brother Sam, her mother died. And my mother had two brothers. One brother was in America, and one brother was with my grandma in the small little town. So he remained with the business.
Mm-hmm. And you were the youngest. Your mother was the youngest.
My mother was the youngest.
Because her mother died.
Yeah, and she had a lot of sisters and brothers. Mm-hmm. You know, but I'm not telling you from that, just from ours. Okay, so my mother had Gershon, Leah, and Sam, and my grandma died at that time. Then I was born.
Mm-hmm.
My father at that time was the war, probably 1917, 1918, wherever it was. You know, what I want to tell you, when I was born, so I don't know what happened, you know, but I'm going to start you to tell you when I'm a little girl.
Mm-hmm.
And my brothers went to private school, and I, as a very small child, they went to a school from city,
right.
But I went to a private school, gymnasium. Starting at I must have been in 1919. Mm-hmm. When I was already a big girl.
Right, right. Your brothers were older and went to the public school.
Yeah. I came, I was Gershon, Leah, Sam, and I'm the fourth one mm-hmm. from the children. Mm-hmm. You know, after me comes my brother Harry, and after Harry comes Auntie Molly, and after Auntie Molly comes Auntie Annette. Okay, I came. And my father was had a store which he made the Putruf's Blecher, they call it. I don't know how it's in English.
Tinsmith.
And tinsmith, they put a tin roof on the house?
The roofs
they used to put, and all different kind of things. But my father never stayed in the store. My father worked with the government. Mm-hmm. He made the samovar, tea kettles, big tea kettles for
the
army.
For the army.
You know, and that's what my father's, he supported. He made tea kettles for, I don't know, for Amelie, you know, and he used to.
So he had the business that made roofs, and then he also had the business that made tea kettles.
Yeah, he didn't bother with a small store. Mm-hmm. He had people doing that, but he was all that. And he was always traveling. Mm-hmm. My father was a very religious man. As he always traveled with the talus and davenan, and my father was a very lively man, beautiful voice, and he played. What did he play with? Didn't I always tell him?
Gramoshka.
Not a gramoshka. Any some kind of instrument. What did you play?
I played a trumpet.
Maybe a trumpet, I don't know, because I remember it was like that. You know, okay, so it was that. And then eventually the war started, and we were a rich home. You know, my mother had asthma always. So she always had a maid in the house, and she used to go away for the whole summer. Mm-hmm. So we had a woman coming in to cook. We used to call her Mime. Mime is Tante in English, you know, which she was not a relative. She just came to cook for us, and we had a maid, which she used to clean the house, mm-hmm. help the children, whatever. And we had a gentile lady coming in twice a month, whatever, to do the laundry, you know. And that's the way I remember as a child.
I go down to see the mail.
Okay, okay, you don't want to hear my story?
I know the story is plenty. Yeah, I look later.
You look later, you listen to the story, okay. So,
eventually the war started. When the war started, they were fighting right by our house. We had a big home and a big garden. The sweet corn was so tall that the soldiers hid it in our garden, and across they hid it in another garden, and they were fighting across and across. Like I, as a child, I remember one soldier, the Chinese people are miserable people. They fight so dirty. So I saw a Chinese soldier having a real long knife, like, they don't call it knife, you know, and he did that to my neighbor's son. Did I tell you that 50
yeah.
times?
Yeah.
With this here, through the heart, and it went through the back. I stayed by the window and watched it, you know.
And who did he do that to?
To my neighbor's son, you know. The Chinese, they're miserable. Such a dirty people. They fight like this. Mm-hmm. Dirty fighters, you know. And they fight it from our Guchten. You know, Guchten is a place where you plant
garden.
Food, gardens. Garden is trees. But we didn't have, we had trees too. I mean flowers. But my father liked
the vegetable garden.
Yeah, my father liked to plant that. Strawberries. I remember my father just like now, just like he's sitting right across the room, you know, and big sugar corn. So
what was
tall.
Your father's name?
David, my doodle, mwah, you know, and then, okay, when the war started,
And your maiden name was what?
My maiden name, the last name, mm-hmm. Brodetsky, Brody. But why is it Brody? Because my father's uncles came here years before. They came two big brothers, and their small little brother was, what was it, maybe 12 years old, they took him with him, you know. And my brother Gershon was then 9 months old when they left. I know it. I heard it 50 times, my mother.
Who was it?
My uncle Louis, my uncle Sam, and my uncle Charlie. My uncle Charlie, and they took my uncle Sam. My uncle Sam was only 12 years old, but they took him with him because my Zaide remarried, you know. Mm-hmm. My Zaide remarried, and my uncle Sam was nursed by that woman, and then my Zaide married her. You know, he was nine months old when my Zaide remarried. So then when he grew up, he was 12 already, and they ran away to America because they didn't want to go to the war. Japan, that was Japan war. Mm-hmm. So they ran away and they took their little brother with them. And with him, and in Europe remained my father, and my younger uncle. What was his name? The one who died here.
Which one are you talking about?
The one who died, my cousin, Harry. My cousin Harry's father, Avram. Mm-hmm. Avram and my father and Moshe. Three sons yet remained in Europe. Three sons, and here three sons. Then there were six brothers, Charlie and Louis and Sam. That's right, six, and there was Avram, David, and Moshe. There were six brothers. Okay. So when it started, the war already, mm-hmm. and the soldiers, it started the war. So our city, the government ran away. The government ran away, so all these peasants came in and they killed all the Jews that night. They just killed them all out. I don't know how my father survived. I couldn't tell you that. You know, at that time I must have been 8 years old. Mm-hmm. So they killed at all. Then the next morning they had to bury, because Jewish people buried them right away the next day. They buried them.
And this was the whole village?
The whole city. The Grad Volinsk is a city, not the village. They killed them. Maybe some remained. My father remained too. You know, my father's brothers, when they killed all the people. And the next day, the government came in. Mm-hmm. What government? We thought that the Bolsheviks come in. They were nice. So another government came in. So over the lake, we were here, in the middle of the lake, here is Novograd-Volinsk, here is the lake, and here is Koretz, Poland. So my uncle and aunt were in Koretz, and we were here. Mm-hmm. But why were we here when it was when the peasants killed all the people and another government came in? So we went, the rabbi and everything, went with music and bread to meet them. They shouldn't kill no more. So over the lake, they thought, they take over the year. So they put fire bombs and they burned the city. When they burned the city, so everybody ran away with whatever they had. I remember, just like now, that my brother Leo, remember my brother mm-hmm. Leo? My mother grabbed the silver. Leo was carried silverware, youngster was carried somewhere else, wherever. And we went 10 miles. The first 10 miles was a hotel, but that time was not a hotel, it was small ones. Where you came in and you had food mm-hmm. and sleep. Food and sleep, and they took care of your horse and buggy. We came with our horse and buggy. Everybody prepared the horse and buggy mm-hmm. in case you have to run. So, okay, we were in that little town. Then, so where should we gonna go? We're gonna go to my mother's city. Because my father came from a big city, from Odessa, mm-hmm. you know. So we are walking with one horse and buggy. Seven children, mother and father is nine, you know. So we came to my mother's city. This is already 1919, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
My father, and nobody had what to eat, but my father always said, my father made from tin little cups, you know,
mm-hmm.
and went to the peasants and gave them this and took potatoes, bread.
In exchange for the silverware.
Nobody had money, you know. Okay, and then he came to the city and my father had a boyfriend. I don't remember his name, but I remember him just like now. He was a shoemaker. And he had typhus, and they didn't have nothing. So my father got a bread, went to see his boyfriend. And typhus, went to see his boyfriend, and then the next day he came home, and he got typhus right away. I don't know, maybe he would have gotten it anyhow, because mm-hmm. I don't believe you get it right away and you're sick right away.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know that. But my father got typhus, and it, and I remember it just like now. He says, Adela, Adela, he called me then Reife. Reife is a doctor. He lived in the same street with us. So I was very bashful. Didn't want to go home. But he started yelling at me. So I went and I called Reife, the doctor. The doctor came and he says, Chava, my mother's name is Chava. Chava, Zorzachnet, Zorzachnet. Du bist ein Samishtach, come on. You verstehst Yiddish? No. Chava, Chava, don't worry yourself. Your husband, David, he's such a strong man, he doesn't mm-hmm. even need me. He lived through any typhus.
Right.
Yeah?
Right.
Okay. On the third day, he couldn't talk already. You know, from typhus, the fever is so, he
right.
can't talk.
Mm-hmm.
And they told him to wait 8 days or whatever. Comes the crisis. Either they live through the crisis or they die, one of the two. But my father never lived through the typhus. Immediately the night, I hear yelling and crying.
Yeah.
My father died at night. And my mother was 34 years old. My father was 42.
So young.
My brother Gershon was 17, that's the oldest child. And then 17, 15, 13, 11, 9, that's the way we went. And we lived with my uncle and aunt, that's my mother's sister, and her husband, Freund, which my friend was named after him.
Mm-hmm.
Such a learned man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we stayed there a year,
mm-hmm.
and then the Americans are coming to help, but they couldn't come to us. We were in Russia. They could only come to Poland.
Which was across the lake.
My uncle and aunt lived there. They came there. They came there and they left money. Yeah, and my Zaide and Baba lived there too. You know, they were young people. I mean, even my Zaide was young. My Zaide later came to America, and when he died, he was only 86 years later. So my mother made the greenets. What is a greenets? You have to, for instance, here is a city, here is lake, here is Russia, here is lake, here is Poland. So you had to go over, nobody should see you. You know mm-hmm. that. And she came there and she say, Hayetl, my tante's name, Hayetl. You know, my uncle was a quiet man, he didn't mix. Hayetl, David's Brüder sind gewesen, zum gelassen Geld verreichen, zum gelassen Geld verreins. Wie ist mein Geld zum gelassen von mir?
In English.
Okay, so she says, They left money for you and they left money for us, for me and my children, where is my money? Mm-hmm. So she says, Chava, whoever holds the pen writes himself to Guten. I haven't got no money for you. And she didn't give her a penny. The only thing I can do for you, leave Gershon and Leah here.
Wait, when your father died, who took the money?
My father died in Russia, in my mother's little city.
Right, and then in Poland.
His brother in the family lived in Poland. Here is Russia, here is Poland,
right,
there.
Right.
So my mother went over the green, you know. She stole there to go over there. She says, Hetel, where is the money which David's brothers left for you and left for me? So she says, Chava, Versal, whoever holds the pen, writes himself to goods.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't got no money for you.
Mm-hmm.
I only have it for me. Hitler killed him. Good. You know. So, the only thing I can do...
That was your father's brother.
My father's brother, mm-hmm. Yeah. The only thing I can do for you, you can leave Gershon and Leah with Bubby and Zaide. See, my father's father was there,
right.
And my father's stepmother,
right.
And my father's sister. So leave them with them and I'll help them go to America. Nobody could go to America. But my brother Leah wasn't 15 years old yet, so he went with the orphan home to America. And my brother was already 17, so he couldn't go. So they helped him to go to Cuba. My brother was 17 when he went to Cuba. So they went to Cuba.
And you're still...
In fear and Russia.
Yeah.
Fear
yeah.
and Russia.
Yeah.
My brother Sam was 13, and I was 10.
You got mail. You have mail.
And I was 10. And we were alone. And mm-hmm. my mother tried to support the family.
Right.
And she had a stand in the market, you know. And my brother Sam was 13, so he used to go to Poland there to bring some stuff to sell, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And we used to hide them, you know. So they once used to come to look for the goods, so my mother wouldn't go. Young woman, 34, she'll go with the soldiers on the roof. So she sent me. I was the oldest girl. I was 10 years old then, 9 or 10. So I went with them, and they looked. They didn't bother me. Years ago, wasn't like that. They didn't touch youngsters. And now we would send a youngster, 9 years old or 8 or whatever I was, on the roof with soldiers.
Mm-hmm.
But anyhow, so we were like that till my brother Gershon came to Cuba, and he found a job as a salesman. My brother Gershon was a very handsome fella.
Mm-hmm.
You remember Uncle Gershon?
In Cuba.
But can you remember Uncle Gershon
mm-hmm.
as a young fella? So when he made the... No, he couldn't afford it. But my brother Leah in America, he was already in America 3 or 4 years, and he had a little money. So he sent it to his older brother, and his older brother sent us money, sent us papers to come to Cuba, couldn't come to America. So that's where we came to Cuba. And 19, you know, time passes by from 19, now it's already 1925. You know, I'm already 15 years old, and my brother Sam was already 17 years old, and my brother Harry was 13 years old. My brother Harry started working in Cuba as a shoemaker when he was 13 years old. We all start working as soon as we reach something. We start working. You know, my mother had 7 children,
mm-hmm.
you know. So, my brother Gershon sent us papers and we came to Cuba. And my brother Gershon rented for us a big room, I told you. And big room, we were 7. And my mother Zaide in 2 roomers. We stand in 1 room. Okay, and everything. Oh, I thought we were so rich. I never knew we were poor. You know, and everybody went to work. What did I go to work for? Maybe you remember Azriel. You remember Azriel?
The tailor.
tailor, yeah. You know, he had a tailor shop in Cuba. He came before us. So he says, Adela came because it's making up a dollar. So what did he do? He showed me how to do it. He put a pirate thread, a button. So I don't remember what he gave me. Gave to my mother, whatever, you know. And like this, we were in Cuba till my brother Leo became a citizen, 21 years old. When my brother Leo...
In Cuba?
Oh, my brother Leo was in America. He came with the orphanage. Mm. He came with the orphanage. But when he came to America, my uncle took him to him. My uncle was to us just like my father. I remember my uncle, you know. Even when we came, I remember my uncle. You know, my aunt didn't let me do nothing. She because we were very pampered children. We came from a rich home. You know, didn't let me do nothing. And my uncle, just like his own daughters, maybe better, you know, mm-hmm. took care of us like that, you know. So we came to so when my brother became a citizen, he could only take over my mother to America. He couldn't take no brothers and sisters. So my mother went to America and left us in Cuba. Left us in Cuba, my brother was already, I don't know, maybe 20, I don't know. And my brother Leah had money. My brother Leah saved every penny for his mother. My sisters and brothers, my brother Leah was like a father to us. He was like a father. So he gave my brother Gershon the money and he opened up a cleaning store. He opened up a cleaning store and we remained in Cuba with my brother. In the meantime, my brother Gershon got married and had a little boy, David. Mm-hmm. And we lived in an apartment and they lived in an apartment. When I say apartment, I mean one room. Mm-hmm. There was no apartments. There was a room. Mm-hmm. There was a big apartment. And he has one room, two room, three room, you know. And in the middle of the apartment was a little kitchen. And everybody came to the kitchen to cook. There was no such a thing as you had your own kitchen or your own bathroom. There was one room, in the middle was a kitchen. Everybody cooked if they had a chance. And in the end of the hall was a bathroom. Mm-hmm. One bathroom. Everybody went there to the bathroom. That's what it was.
Mm-hmm. This is the same building that Zaide's living in.
Yeah, I told you, it's a room. Yeah. We lived in this room, he lived in this room, mm-hmm. you lived in this room.
Right, right.
You had the same kitchen, you had the same toilet.
The same building.
Yeah, you had the same toilet, you know. But nobody knew that they're that poor. I never knew I'm that poor, never. Even when I got married, I didn't know I'm poor.
Wait a minute, let me tell you something.
Okay, let me finish it, you know. Okay, so we were already in Cuba, and my mother is already a citizen, and she took over already. My brother took over my mother. Then my mother came to America, and she gave in the citizenship papers. As soon as she gave in the citizenship papers, I think it had to be a year, 2 years, I don't remember. You know, I really cannot remember all this.
2 years.
So much. Okay, when she came to America and she gave him the citizen papers, then she could send papers for her children. Then she sent papers for us. So we couldn't come all together. So Sam and Molly and I could come before. Also.
Because you were the youngest.
No. Harry and Annette. My brother Harry and Annette are the youngest. Harry is after me. I'm older than my brother Harry for 2 years. And I'm older than my sister Molly for 4 years. And I'm older from my sister Annette for 6 years. We're 2 years apart. You know, okay, when my mother sent the papers and we came to America, my uncle Louis, and Aiden Zalazine, just like my father. They took care of us just like took them to their home. My hand didn't let me do nothing. No, man kin. You know, and we were by my Uncle Louis, and My Uncle Sam found me a job, which I never knew how to do it.
Right, you were sewing.
But he told them that I know. The J.L. Hudson's drapery.
This is where you worked in Philadelphia, J.L. Hudson's?
No, here in Detroit.
In Detroit.
Oh, you came directly to
Dean
Detroit.
We never came to Philadelphia. We came to Detroit.
Oh, oh, I didn't. Leo lived in Detroit.
I got married in Philadelphia.
Ah.
You got married here.
Yeah, we got married here, but we moved to Philadelphia. 24 hours, the whole night. The animal.
When she was living in Detroit, you were living in Philadelphia.
Yeah. Right. Well, I'll tell you that. So, Sam and I and Molly came here. So my Molly used to know so better than I. She could sew better than I. So she got us a job in a department store. I forgot already the name.
Colonial
Department. And I got a job at J. Lutz's. Mm-hmm. And my brother Sam got a job for painting. $20 a week, I want you to know. That's a lot of money that time.
He was making that a night in Cuba.
He didn't make. That's my uncle's got a job for my brother. Because my uncle was in real estate business. So he had painters working for him. So they had to take his nephew. Mm-hmm. And there was no question about it. So Jay Lutzen took me. They kept me every week. Then they said they hadn't got no work for me. Then I was already myself.
What year is this?
What year is that?
1938.
No, I was 4 years in Cuba.
Good.
Answer the phone in the kitchen.
Hello? Yeah. Fine, how are you?
Well, I'll come down and I'll take him back. Mm-hmm. And I'll do it myself. I don't have to go.
Okay, so you're working and they say they don't have a job for you.
So we came here and this is already 1929. So I worked there a week and right away they just had to give me a job because Uncle Sam was there, big customer. He was a real estate and he made all the drapes and he's a, you know. Okay, then I go already myself to look for a job.
Because they fired you.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. So I worked there a week, so I said I know already how to, so you know how to work. So I come to a place where they make onyx, real heavy material. Onyx, for summer.
Oh, onyx. Hammocks.
Onyx.
That you lay between in a tree?
No.
No?
Onyx, you put it on the
roof. Onyx.
You know how to work a machine? Yeah. Where did you work? Jay Lutz's. I really did work Jay Lutz's a week. Never seen it. So they sent me down and they gave me a machine. And that is a thread machine. I don't know how to thread a machine. I never saw a machine. So a girl helps me to thread the machine. Thread a machine? What do you do with a machine? I don't know. So another girl showed me how to do that. So she showed me already how to thread a machine. And another girl showed me how to put it in the machine. Yeah? You still know what to do. A third girl showed me how to do that. I worked there a day. Then by the end of the day, he gave me 50 cents or whatever you had to give me, that's it. You don't have to come tomorrow. But I know already how to thread a machine, and I know already how to put it in the machine,
uh-huh.
I know already how to do that. Hey, I know already how to sew, yeah? Then my sister Molly worked in a department store. She made $18 a week. I made the Hudson's $20 a week. Only worked 1 week, but I still made $20 a week. So my sister Molly says, I'll take you into to the
Colonial
department store. They'll give you a job. They need a helper and sewing. There I then helped sewing for Jay Lutz's drapery, mm-hmm. Fancy, and sewing a whole week. So I say, yeah, of course I know. I worked for
Jay Lutz's.
I worked for Jay Lutz's in the fancy draperies. Really fancy drink. Okay, how much did you make a week? I made $20 a week. Okay, go ahead. I started working there for $20. My sister only made $18 a week. My sister mother says, Ida, look at that. I took you into the job. I make $18 a week. You make $20 a week. You got to give me a dollar. Okay, I give you. Doesn't make any difference. My mother took every penny anyway. She gave me $1 for the week, and she gave her $1 for the week. So, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And she gave my brother Sam $1. Everybody got $1.
And it paid the bills for the...
No, what do we need $1 for? For carfare. We need, it costs 5 cents carfare and $2 a transfer, because we had to take 3 streetcars mm-hmm. to go to work. I worked on 4th Street. You know where 4th Street is?
By the bridge. By the,
bridge near the where you go to Canada. I used to take 3 streetcars. So 5 cents and 2 cents for a transfer is 7 cents a day. 5 times 7 is 21. Then we bet 25 cents for, we used to go to shop. My mother saw that we are intelligent people. Go to shop. The 25 cents per shop. So you have already 45 or whatever. And the rest for coffee. We used to buy coffee, 5 cents a coffee. Mm-hmm. They used to come to the factory with coffee. Well, I came there, and the factory is machines, like that long machines, you know, and everybody sits in a place. If you go away, the machine runs anyhow. So the foreman watched you. You shouldn't go more than a minute. The machine is running. Do you understand what I'm telling you?
It's all one thing that keeps going.
Right.
That's right. Yeah. So if you go away, your machine
it piles up.
Your machine is nothing piles up because you don't put in. But your machine is running anyhow, the electricity. So you watch, you shouldn't go for too long. So you go for too long, so what did you do here? You planted something there. What did I do? I knew already how to sew. Remember they showed me how to sew? I finished up cotton dresses, aprons. So here, every dress is finished like that.
Mm-hmm.
Here, then goes the machine. Phew! Myself and Irene Goldstein's were the fastest in the whole factory. 300 girls. Imagine that, and I didn't know nothing. You know, when they needed something fast, what did they pay a dozen? To finish up dresses a dozen.
10 cents a dozen.
What are you talking about?
How much?
3 cents a dozen.
No.
On top, but you made $20 a week plus 3 cents a dozen.
No, there they didn't pay you by the week.
Oh, this is a
they
different
They made place. You by the dozen.
Right.
They used to bring a packet of dresses, 30 dozen. You know, and you used to, you know, you're young, you have koyach, you didn't have a heart attack. You know, I used to make so much that we didn't hide the ticket lach, not to show them that we made so much. Used to make $7 a week. That's too much money, you know. Anyway, so I worked in that place till we got married. When he came for the wedding, what day did he come? It was
but
a holiday.
How did you decide to get married? You had known him in Cuba.
I knew him from Cuba.
Yeah.
I knew the other guy from Cuba too,
right.
Which he was supposed to call me by his name already.
Mm-hmm.
The other fella wanted to see. We have rich uncles, so tell your uncles to send me money, then we'll get married. I told them, hop, dear and bud, I have 50 boys for one. I was a youngster, a good-looking girl, and I had a beautiful voice. I always was singing. Guess your father,
you
the year Zaide, I always was singing. A beautiful girl, a singer, a dancer, and I need him to ask my uncles for money. Who asked for my money? I didn't even answer them, nothing. Just to correspond. Then he saw that I don't come there. Sneaky. So he started writing to me that we are for each other. He's still in Cuba.
Mm-hmm.
That we are for each other, will be good for each other. In the meantime, I didn't get younger. My sister thought I'm an old maid already. My sister, Annette, is... 6 years younger than I am. So when I was 18, so she was what? 14. So she used to call me old maid. Yeah. Then she wasn't bashful for me. Neither. So I said, my God, what am I going to see till I'm going to get old again? So he wrote me that, you know.
Did your friend know that you were writing her?
I don't think so.
So he kept on writing me. So he's still in Cuba. He's not here.
I was in Philadelphia.
But you came in Philadelphia in 1932. Yeah. Why can't you listen to me?
Yeah.
When you came in Philadelphia and you open up the stand, you're a rich fella. Just to say, buy yourself a ring. I send you the money. You see, you are not yourself. You know, he's not like the Hanuman, the uncle. He bought me. He sent me money for a ring. He said, order yourself a poor coat. Yeah.
So you went to Philadelphia and you had a stand like you had in Cuba. That's where you got the money to send her the coat.
Yeah. He sent me money for a ring. He sent me, Daddy didn't send me money. He just said, order yourself a pork. I told him I ordered myself a pork in so much money, I don't remember what. And I said, okay, we'll get married. So I bought myself a ring and I'm engaged. He's there.
In Cuba?
I'm engaged. No. I've been there. He came to Philadelphia already.
In Philadelphia.
That's already in 1932.
Mm-hmm.
And 1932, yeah. And he sends me maybe a year later, because 2 years later we got married already, mm-hmm. in 1934. So he said, order yourself, buy yourself a ring, and order yourself a fur coat. And I'm engaged girl.
You're a wealthy man in Philadelphia.
Why are you talking about? I'm engaged girl. With a diamond ring, and I had showers, and my aunt gave me a tea, you know, very rich tea, big hotel, you know, and he didn't come to no shower or anything, and and I bought my own wedding gear. What do you have to buy before you get married?
Certificate, license.
License, that's a marriage license. I got marriage license. I attended everything myself.
I come in there.
I attended everything myself. Attended the wedding. My brother Leon, my brother Sam, my brother Gershon. They were not. Gershon wasn't here. Gershon was in Cuba. He couldn't come here, you know, because Cuba didn't even let him in. Okay, Gershon came here in 19. He came here from Philadelphia. In 1942.
Mm-hmm. Much later.
Yeah, later.
So you're going to get married in Detroit.
Really? Yeah, we get married in Detroit. We have already planned everything. And he comes 4 days before the wedding. And it's a Yontif something. Sure. Some kind of holiday. What is the kind of holiday in February the 14th? Swedish Day, something
else. Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day. He comes. I didn't know nothing. He didn't know nothing. He's supposed to bring a gift again, a girlfriend, yeah? But he didn't know. I didn't know neither. So it's okay. So he came, but my mother made a nice supper. And Friday, she invited the whole family. And then my brother Leah was married already. My sister Lahaine baked a big cake. It was beautiful, in the thing for the family. That was Friday, yeah? And Sunday we got married. We got married. You see the picture, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
In a nice synagogue, and with music, nice wedding. Where did we get the wedding, the money for it? Why don't you ask for
it? From your uncle.
No, we didn't have, from my husband, he didn't have that much money.
Yeah.
When he came, we went shopping. The bride was very rich. So he bought me a pair of shoes, he bought me...
Hold on.
From your husband? I said, no, my husband didn't have it. So I'm going to tell him where we got the money. Where did we get the money, Freddy? Exactly. From the gifts. Everybody came in and gave you a gift.
Yeah, $5 bill, $10 bill.
Okay, son. Okay. Yeah. Irony, Freddy darling, don't buy it for me. I see it by you over there. I don't need a son. Yeah, I know all about it. And when I talk about it now, I cry. Okay, son. My father loved these children, so you never seen my sons are good as my sons are just as good husbands like my father, my sons, not my husband, because my husband never could, because he was working. He never had a chance, my poor husband. You know, but my sons are as good as my father. My father. My father never went to sleep before covering his child. Saturday morning, he gave milk to his child with the coffee cake, which my mother used to bake, Kirbach. You know, my father was... Okay, so what am I talking
about? So you had your wedding.
So we had a wedding. Where do you get the money? You had to pay the music. And I had music, and I catered a fair. You see the picture, you know? And my brother, Leo, was just like my... He was taking care of us like my father. When we were in Italian between, when we came from Cuba, right away, the same evening or the next evening, he took us to J.L. Hudson's, in basement naturally, bought us new clothes, new shoes, new winter coats, everything. My brother Leo worked and saved every penny for his brothers and sister, for his mother to support the family. That's mm-hmm. the brothers I have. When I
what did he do? You said he was a salesman.
No, he was an upholsterer. Mm-hmm. You know, when I got sick, when I had a palpitation, and my brother Sam came in, you remember my brother Sam? Mm-hmm. Albert, call the best doctors, don't worry about money, here's money, anything you want. My brother Sam, and he wasn't a rich man, but as soon as they came in, he says, call the very best, and my sister Ida. That's the way.
Don't talk too much.
But that's the way my brothers, you see, my brothers were older than I am. Yeah. I was a little sister. And then came the other ones. My brothers took care of us just like they would be our father.
Mm-hmm. Was a bunch of bums.
And my mother
a bunch of bums?
My mother was a very pampered woman, you know. My mother was always used to going on vacation every summer. She wasn't used to doing the housework and nothing, you know. And
so you got married. He came 4 days before the wedding.
Okay, so over the
wedding. So you paid for the wedding with the gift money.
My brother.
But you keep everything you had, you never mark it down.
No. My brother was sitting by the door. Yeah. And you came in, Mr. and Mrs. Ian Rubinstein. Oh, here's a gift for the new couple. Oh, thank you. In his pocket. I never seen it. Poor guy never saw it. You know. So, yeah, the money to pay for the wedding. Then my mother, I took my mother to the eye doctor. She said she needed glasses. She never needed glasses. She never needed a hearing aid. You know, my mother died at 92. She never needed. But she said she needed. I took her to the doctor, and she needed glasses. Didn't have the money to take her the glasses. So I said, I'll send you the money for the glasses afterwards. You know. So we just had... My brother Leo just had for the wedding, and we didn't have enough to take. He came with the bus just one way. One way. So we landed. From whom did we land money?
Your brother Sam.
My brother Sam. So we landed from my brother Sam money.
How much money?
Whatever it costs to go with the bus back.
$7.
24 hours. 24 hours we went.
I was showing the
seven straight days. From the wedding, I slept with my sister Molly and my sister Annette. I was so bashful. What do you mean? I slept with them straight bed. You know, I slept with them. But then we landed, how much it cost? $7 to go back to Philadelphia with the bus, 24 hours.
Then we
came to Philadelphia, and he had a stand, took in a few dollars. So the first week, I said, and my mother's almost she had a fish alignment. I sent my mother the, I don't remember how much it was, the money for her glasses.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and I was already married lady, right? So my mother
so
got...
So you had a stand at this point in a hotel or on the street?
No, on the street. In Philadelphia... Street.
Was it a push cart or a stand?
No, let me explain.
But it's still
in Philadelphia, it goes like that. Here is the building.
Mm-hmm.
Building. Upstairs, just two floors. Upstairs is the rooms. Here, the building has two windows. Here a window, here the door. Here's this one standing at this window, one standing at this window. And here, if you're rich, you're in the old store. And if you're rich, like Mr. Albert Rubinstein, you're in the half store with one window and one stand. The other half is another fella, a half a window and a half a stand. Mm-hmm. You have a half a kitchen, the other, but what means a half a kitchen? It's one stove, but you have a little table to work with, and the other woman. Upstairs is two rooms. You have one room which belongs to this other store. This has one room which belongs to this other store. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I had already two children in that store. See, my doodle was 4 years old already, and my framework was just born in that store.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So
what was the store called? Did it have a name?
Oh, sure. Albert's department store. We had socks, and we had yarn, and we had shoelaces.
Yeah. Shoe polish.
And we had shoe polish. And I think we had some underwear for me.
No, underwear, Zuki got the underwear.
Oh, yeah. So what did we add? Anything else?
Cosmetic.
Yeah, you know.
Who had the other store? What was the man's name?
Jenny, and what was his name, Albert?
Handler.
We were very good friends. You know, Sam.
They had schmucks. They had like socks and underwear.
Yeah, this was, we didn't have a day yet. You know. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we were in that store, and my friend was born already. And we made cash and vaso.
Mm-hmm.
Vaso of kasha. That means we made enough for the water, but not for the cereal. Very rich people. I never knew that I'm poor. All my life, I never knew that I'm poor.
Mm-hmm.
Even now, I think I'm very rich, which I am. You know, maybe some people would call it poor. I call it very rich, you know. That's the way I always please. I'm always pleased with what I have.
Yeah.
You know. Okay. So my husband decided. Yeah. My Uncle Sam died.
Mm-hmm.
My Uncle Sam died, so he left every child $1,000. And my mother $3,000.
Which was a lot of money.
At that time, it's a lot of money. So I had $1,000. And every child had $1,000, send us
$1,000.
My mother had $3,000. My mother gave it to the older chum for my father, obituary care. And she bought for herself a cemetery plot. For herself, her children shouldn't be bothered. Okay. My husband decided, my Uncle Sam left $1,000 when he died. Uncle Louis was very rich. My Uncle Louis, when we came to America in 1929, so he's so rich that he left already. He had four girls, so he made a bill for each girl, $5,000. So he said, go to Uncle Louis, maybe he'll help us a little. He comes to Uncle Louis, says, are you Schnorr? He tells your father, you know what Schnorr is?
No.
You are nothing. You going to have two children when you have enough just for water and not for the cereal. And you come to beg for money. Albert, did he give you something or not? Didn't give nothing. He says, if you could have children, work and support them. So the poor guy comes back. He says, okay. And I wanted to go back to Detroit. I wanted to go back to Detroit so badly. To my mother, my brothers, my sisters. So let's go back to Detroit anyhow. So we rented. What did we rent it?
A truck.
A truck for our furniture. Oh yeah. His uncle bought us a new bedroom set when we got married. And a kitchen set. So we had a kitchen set.
And a frigidaire.
The vegetarian.
This is your mother's brother who lived in Philadelphia.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's Rubinstein. Mm-hmm. His name is correct, his mother's name, Rubinstein. But my son, David asked, how come Rubinstein? So he was always with his mother's family. Why should he have...
I didn't even know his my father.
Yeah, he never even knew his father or anything. His mother's name is good enough. So, we rented that truck. And we took our bedroom set and our kitchen set. And we had a refrigerator, Albert.
Sure, the refrigerator was lame.
Did we have a washer? No, no.
No.
We didn't have the washer. Wash my hand at times. I had a rich life.
Okay.
We come here. Where do we come? To my mother.
Mm-hmm. What year did you come here to back to Detroit?
1940. Your father was 4 months old. We come to my mother. And the next day, your father goes to look for a store. He finds a store in a Polish neighborhood. Store maybe.
Way before I find a store, how's that?
Store maybe. As big as this year, the old store.
How did you find the store?
Went to look.
No. I went to look in Shane Street, you know, you heard Shane.
Polish neighbor.
Polish neighbor. Passed by, I see a store, and I find out they asked $35 a month for rent.
The store?
They give me the key, and I look, and I come in, and I see the apartment. They have the whole apartment in the back, kitchen, bedroom, everything for $35. Then our two brothers are painters. They come and they paint it up, they clean it up, everything. We moved a couple of days, we moved.
Away from your mother's house into the store.
Yeah, we moved to our own store. Well, first you have to have goods in the store.
What?
Why don't you tell how you got goods in the store?
I tell you first. No, later I tell you.
Okay, we're moving there. The first night, my Freyman lays in the car, in Bethlehem, in the crib, and here it's snowing. Go to see my baby. The baby's full of snow. You know, from the roof comes the snow right in the house, right on my baby. Oi! I catch my baby. Called my mother. Mother.
What's the matter, you girl? Come on. Why do you act silly, see?
And it was my dad that was so cold.
Your father was 4 months old. Mother be coming back, it's snowing. Okay, my kin, what could you do to me?
Right.
I'll be grab a cab. We go back to my mother.
Yeah.
And he keeps the store, the store.
Did you fix the roof?
No, he didn't make a living. Didn't even make enough for paying the rent. So we were there and eventually looked for a store. If we rented a store on Woodrow Wilson, on Woodrow Wilson we done very good, you know. We bought a new home for $10,000 cash.
Your store was on Woodrow Wilson and you bought your house because of that store?
We bought the house on San Juan. What a beautiful home.
$10,000.
Nowadays the floors was by fancy furniture. We covered it, we waited a year for carpet. From Jay Lutz's. But that time, we waited a year for the drapes. We done good in 19. The war came, and the girls put socks on, and the factories were working. And
the war came along.
Well, anyhow, we rented that store, and we were in that store till we moved to a Polish neighborhood again. In it?
Yeah.
Oh, then we moved to Dexter.
7 miles
and then we moved to Dexter. Oh yeah, we went broke again. On 700 there, we went broke again. Because they moved out from there, they went fancy, 14 mile road, isn't that? So we went broke again. So eventually, we lost our car. And this is already, David is already 18 years old, and David is in service. He wanted to go to service. David finished high school. We were so well before the macabre.
This is with the World War. This is before the store went under.
Yeah.
No, the store went. Yeah, before the store went under, because we could afford to buy David a car. Mm-hmm. He's 18. He graduated high school. He went to college. He said he wants to go to University of Michigan. He couldn't afford it, but they said, okay, my son. So I had a girl helping me with that because I was working with a baby. She says, okay, my son. I let the girl go, and I'm the maid myself, you know. And I rent the store, and I rent my child, and I rent. And David went to you. So, yeah, David went to service already. Mm-hmm. And I don't know, we were, when David was in service, we were on 7 Mile Road.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, we were on 7 Mile Road. We were on 7 Mile Road for a few years. And then the people moved out from, started like when we were in, up here in Farmington, and people start moving out. So you move with them. Mm-hmm. So they moved out. But we didn't move with them. We moved on decks, and we've done very good on decks. Till the fire, and now you know already.
Well, I want to hear about the riots before you moved to Detroit, well, before you moved to Farmington.
But it was a fire on Dexter. Mm-hmm. 1956?
Yeah. No. When we opened up the store in Dexter, and that time was in 67, was the riot. And your father had to go for collecting, you know, for the insurance.
Oh,
with a quarter of a week, something, a dollar
he
a week.
He didn't want to be
Why don't you let me?
Wait, because Freddy graduated
high school.
David was a CPA. No, college. What's the matter with you? Your father graduated college. What was he? David finished CPA and Freddy finished accounting. Mm-hmm. But he couldn't sit in a chair accounting. Mm-hmm. So he got a job, what is that? Collecting insurance. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So when it was the fire and your father went collecting insurance, you say they didn't know what to do, you went with him. He goes collecting insurance. Where did he go up? A prostitute house. You know, which was, mm-hmm. when a prostitute house, it's not just a prostitute, it's everything else. You know, it's junk and this and that. So your father, your Zaide said, my kid, you're not going there anymore. You're coming with me. So your father went with your Zaide to look for a store. And they found a store in Farmington Hills.